10-year-old Ashton Raspberry was helping his younger brother build a treehouse in the woods behind their house in Washtenburg in Greene County.
So I walked out there and I was where the wood was. So then I swung my leg around and then it just bit me.
A copperhead snake had bitten Ashton on the leg.
Felt like 5 or 6 wasps sting me at the same time. First I looked around and I couldn't see nothing. And then I looked at my leg and I thought it was just briars, but then I saw a little bit of bruising. And I started running then.
He didn't know that's what it was. He thought he stepped in like a nest of ground wasps or something. He didn't realize. And I think within probably 5 or 10 minutes, that's when it started bruising up. And my oldest son looked at it, saw the actual puncture marks, and knew this is a snake bite.
Together, the brothers applied a tourniquet. Everyone raced to the hospital.
We just prayed the whole way there, just prayed. And I called the ER, children's ER, to let them know we were on our way so that they'd have things in place they knew when we walked in the door. And so my husband, we got there, he got the boys out, I parked, and then that's when it hit me that this is what's happening. And as soon as I walked in the door, I believe it was the receptionist that grabbed my arm and she said, "It's okay, the snake doctor's here, it's okay."
Now this guy is dangerous, big style.
Dr. Sean Bush is the snake doctor.
So that's why I have him in this bag.
You might get that impression from the collection of snake fangs on his bookcase. There's also a DVD of the television show he starred in, Venom ER.
They're not gonna just crawl his bag and seek and destroy you, right? They're just like, just being snakes, being kind of dumb, not that smart.
It's the way Dr. Bush handles creatures that would rattle most of us that confirms that nickname, the snake doctor.
The snake's not rattling for your benefit. The snake is rattling for its own benefit so that you don't step on it.
Speaking of rattled, this is a 10-foot-long timber rattlesnake. Its bite could be fatal.
I mean, snakes are like one of the most dangerous animals on the planet. They really are. And so people have learned through the millennia, I guess, to treat them with respect. They can be very dangerous, even deadly. But at the same time, I don't think snakes are like innately evil. They're just a snake.
Dr. Bush combined his desire to be a doctor with a lifelong interest in reptiles to specialize in treating the bites of snakes and other venomous creatures. He's written more than 50 publications about treating bites and stings. He's traveled the world lecturing about snakes and snake bites, and he's appeared on dozens of television shows to talk about snakes. It's a passion and a mission. With the timber rattlesnake safely put away, Dr. Bush then brought out a copperhead snake.
So that's the copperhead, and he's not that dangerous, so you don't have to worry about him.
So I'm okay?
You're okay. I'll let you know when you're not.
This creature is what brought him from California to North Carolina to join the staff at East Carolina University's Brody School of Medicine. That's because North Carolina leads the nation in copperhead bites. The copperhead is just one of 6 venomous snakes in the state. The list also includes the rattlesnake, the cottonmouth, and the coral snake. Dr. Bush treats, on average, 1 snake bite victim per week.
As soon as the snake's fang penetrates your skin and goes into your subcutaneous tissue, it starts to digest it, among other things. And digestion can't be reversed. You gotta stop it. And the sooner you stop it, the better, because that will help you avoid a lot of the healing process that you have to do, and you may avoid irreversible injury.
Within minutes of Ashton's arrival at the hospital, Dr. Bush had prepared and administered anti-venom.
So actually, Dr. Bush, I remember him saying that day, time is tissue when it comes to these types of emergencies, because of course the venom is breaking down the tissue from the time that it is, enters into the wound.
So we're going to do a study about copperheads.
As it turns out, Ashton's case will be part of a study Dr. Bush is launching on alternative treatment methods for copperhead snake bites. The question, whether anti-venom is always needed, or, in the case of mild bites, is it better to allow the venom to simply dilute in the bloodstream?
Anti-venom costs about $2,300 a vial.
Anti-venom is constructed from the venoms of different snakes. It's made to be generic for all pit vipers, which includes rattlesnakes, copperheads, and cottonmouths.
There's a controversy as to whether you even need to use anti-venom, which is expensive and can be associated with side effects. So we're going to do a study here that compares patients treated with anti-venom against patients treated without anti-venom.
As for what to do if someone is bitten by a snake, Dr. Bush says forget the Hollywood treatments like a tourniquet. Just get to the hospital as quickly as possible. And a good rule of thumb, if you see a snake, stay two giant steps away from it.
So hold on, so if I'm the snake and I'm right here.
Yeah.
Where should you be?
Well, I'm right here. I'm not in your strike range. I'm not suppose that the biggest rattlesnake in North Carolina is an eastern diamondback and it's 8 feet long or upwards of 8 feet long.
Okay.
The snake can strike about half, maybe two-thirds its body length, right? So if it strikes half or even two-thirds, I mean, you're good at math. What's that? That's 4 to 6 feet, right?
Right.
So if you're more than 6 feet away from me, you're out of the snake strike range. You can take pictures and send them to your friends and put them on Facebook, whatever.
And Dr. Bush says if you need to move the snake, use tools, such as a shovel or a hook.
Like timber rattlesnake, it's an American icon. Eastern diamondback, American icon. So why would you kill this magnificent animal? You don't have to kill it. You're human, you're smart. You can use tools and you can move the animal to a place where it can thrive and survive.
We have honestly witnessed a miracle, to be very honest with you. I mean, it's a miracle. Hey!
By the way, as I was finishing my interview with Ashton's mom, Dr. Bush happened by, and Ashton was more than happy to show off his still-recovering, snake-bitten leg. There is still discoloration, but it is healing, and it's another case study
How you feeling?
For the snake doctor.